Hello, Darren from DrayTek Australia in New Zealand. DrayTek VigorConnect is a TR069 based management system to manage up to 100 DrayTek access points and switches on the local network. It's suitable for businesses with multiple Vigor access points and Vigor switches located within a building on the same local area network. In this video, I'll show you the process of discovering access points on your LAN and adding them to the VigorConnect management console so they can be monitored and managed. VigorConnect can be installed on any PC running Windows 7 or higher. It's also recommended that all APs are running the latest firmware. The software can either be downloaded from this page on draytek.com.au, which you'll find under Products, Network Management Tools, VigorConnect, then just scroll down towards the bottom and click the download link. Or from the Downloads page under Support, Downloads, then scroll down to Software and click Download. It's also available on draytek.com. Once it's finished downloading, run the installation program. If you get this prompt from Windows Defender, click on More Info, then Run Anyway. Click OK and Next and Install. And that'll take a minute or so to install now. Near the end of the installation, you'll get this prompt to change any of the default parameters. If you don't need to change anything, or you don't know what these settings are anyway, just click OK to that. Then click on Finish, then the setup wizard will close. We can also close that, and the program will start automatically by opening a new tab in your default web browser. At the login prompt, enter the username root and password admin123, as well as the validation code. It's recommended to change the username and password for security reasons. Then you'll see a prompt to scan and set up APs using the wizard. I'll click No to that because we can come back to that later. To come back to the dashboard later, you can either bookmark this URL or you'll find an icon on the desktop of your PC to allow you to start the application manually. Now we're logged in and we're greeted with the dashboard page, and we're now ready to start discovering access points on the same LAN. To start the discovery process, click on the Discover button on the dashboard. Wait a few seconds and you'll see a list appear. Here we have one access point discovered. You'll need to change the username and password if those aren't the default values, and then click on Add. It may take a minute, but once added, it will appear in the unknown devices list as well as on the left over here in the device overview list. If you have any trouble adding an AP, or if no APs are found after clicking the Discover button, make sure the Windows Defender firewall is turned off on the public network and try again. To change it to a known device and add it to a network, click the plus sign. We have selected root network here. Enter the device location and set to known device and click apply to save. Now we can go back to the main menu and find our new AP under the root network. Here we can select it and bring up its own dashboard page instead of the root network dashboard. This will give us lots of information about the AP status, such as the device name, IP address, the model, firmware version, and MAC address. It'll also show us which ports are active. And down the bottom here, we can backup or restore configurations, download the latest config, or reboot the app. One useful feature in VigorConnect is to load a floor plan of your building and use it to work out where the access points should be placed to achieve the best coverage. To do this, go back to the root network dashboard and down to monitoring. Click on floor plan, then click on add new profile. Enter a profile name, I'll call this one office. Then browse to the floor plan image we want to use. Once this is done, click on Continue, then click on Add Device, find our AP over on the right and drag it over to the required location on the map. If you can't see the whole floor plan, you can zoom out over here and then drag again to its proper location. Then save. Now we can click on Browse View and select our created profile to see our floor plan with the location of all the APs. Other monitoring features are alarms, logs, and rogue AP detection. Next, in the configuration menu, you can create configuration profiles for the access points, which can be rolled out to other APs in the network. Other functions in the system menu, down under maintenance, we can schedule backups, restore configs, we can upgrade firmware, set schedules, network management, we can delete APs we don't want anymore. System parameters. Under user management, we can see who's logged into VigorConnect, and in the About section, we can check for updates. Okay. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au. Don't forget to like and subscribe below and give the bell a click if you'd like a notification of new videos as they go up. Thanks and bye for now.